Nel nome del Padre, Figliolo, Spirito Santo. Amen.
Such a separation.
All righty. Thank you, Reverend Tony. Appreciate it. Good morning, good afternoon. It all depends on, and even good evening. It all depends on where you are at, you know, right now in this world that we are in, and so many different time zones. It's a beautiful thing. And it's always good just to be here, just to be in this moment, and just to be able to have the opportunity to, you know, share my thoughts as it, you know, relates to the Course of Miracles. You know, one of the things I've always say, and I always like to acknowledge the fact that, you know, I do see this as a, you know, wonderful privilege to be able to do that, because I recognize that not everyone has the opportunity to be able to be in this space, to be able to present this way for a variety of different reasons. And so, and I'm someone who always just want to be very mindful of that, and to really be able to, you know, understand that, you know, aspect of it. And then one of the things that I also always do is I like to, you know, take the time to turn it over to the Holy Spirit to be able to ask for guidance on what is it that the Spirit feels that I am guided to share, you know, and regarding aspect of it, any specific topic. And normally it is a topic that has to, you know, relate to what's going on with me in my, you know, own life, and just me, you know, regarding my, you know, own, you know, journey, you know, regarding that aspect of it. You know, and, you know, one of the things that I, you know, realized and that I, you know, recognized when I turned it over to the Holy Spirit, and when the Spirit was guiding me on what is it that they would like for me to talk about it, you know, it came very clear that it was about, you know, growing, you know, out of the dark into the light. And I was remember thinking about, okay, what is it about, you know, getting out of the dark, you know, growing into the light that I need to experience right now and in my life, you know, regarding that aspect of it. And then it dawned on me, it's like, well, you know what, I will be turning 55 in a couple of weeks. And, you know, which I'm very, you know, excited about. And so it just gave me an opportunity to just reflect, you know, on my life, and just to reflect, you know, where I'm at, you know, in my life regarding that aspect of it. And one of the things that, you know, stood out for me, you know, when I was, you know, reflecting on my life and just, you know, really thinking about my topic today, you know, out of the dark into the light, is just recognizing how fortunate I have been since the Course came into my life. It has helped me evolve and to shift in ways that I never thought possible. Because throughout my life, I especially before, you know, the Course entered my life, you know, I experienced a lot in my mind, what I consider a lot of darkness, you know, a lot of things that normally could have, you know, really, you know, kept a lot of people down, you know, if I would allow myself to stay stuck in that moment, you know, recognizing that, you know, I, you know, come from a, you know, background where, you know, I had a lot of grief in my life very early on, and then even later on in my life, and how much that darkness could have really, really stuck with me. Because, you know, when you get so much depth, you know, it can easily put you in a frame of mind of just like, what's the point if everyone's going to continue to make their transition in your life, you know, regarding that aspect of it. And but yet, you know, because of the Course, I've been able to see things differently and be able to see the light, you know, even in things that, you know, makes their, you know, their transition, you know, regarding that aspect of it. So I'm grateful for that. I'm, you know, really grateful that I have been able to learn and shift and to be able to evolve in ways that I never even, you know, thought possible, you know, regarding, you know, that aspect of it. And I also, you know, recognize that, you know, in this world, things still comes up for us. There's still some challenges. There's still things that I continue to, find myself, struggling with, regarding that aspect of it. And so when I know I was thinking about this whole thought of out of the dark, and into the light, the thing that kept coming to my mind is that it really is about learning how to shift my own thought or my own perspective when it come to my appearance of what I consider, darkness. And for me, I'm in a dark mind or state of mind is when I'm in a sense of fear. If I am a sense of where I'm being very judgmental, if I'm feeling like this sense of guilt, and if I'm in a space where I'm not being very forgiving. Those are some of the things that I, recognize, for me, where I see that as a sense of darkness, when I'm in that state of mind, because when I'm in that state of mind, I am not coming from a very loving, healing place regarding that aspect of it. I am not seeing the light that actually really does exist, not only in me, but the light that actually exists in this world that we are in regarding that aspect of it. And so for me, I had to, really start looking at that and starting to see, what that is, about. And then recognizing that, fortunately, I have the skill set, to be able to have the awareness of it and yet being able to find a way to be able to shift it because studying the course, which, been very, helpful for me, and it reminded me of numerous incidents that happened recently. But one just, a couple that happened, this week, which is very interesting in how our mind, works and how it can get into that darkness. The first, incident, happened that came to my mind when I, realized of how much I was into my negativity and not really in a good space was I had just got me my breakfast at our my Poached Bagel in my neighborhood, my typical, egg and cheese bagel with cinnamon raisin and all that stuff. And then a friend of mine called me when I was on my way back to my car. And so then on the way, there's a car that wanted to, make a right turn. And so I was walking and all that stuff. And so then driver made, some comment about me walking and all that stuff. And then I yelled out, "Well, it's your job to be able to, pay attention to whenever there's a pedestrian." And then I, realized and took a second and said, "Wait a minute here. Honestly, actually, I was actually in a room because I was actually walking on a red light, and they actually are the ones who's supposed to be, making the right turn, regarding that aspect of it." But immediately, I went to that negativity and putting the blame on them, and then I may realize, "Wow, that's darkness, Vincent. You're taking something out on someone because actually, honestly, I'm the one who, did the red light. And to be honest, I was on the phone talking. And so I wasn't really paying attention." And so it was just a, eye-opening, waking that up. And because then when I was in my car, and even my friends like, "Wow, you're very riled up," the person who I was talking to. And I was just like, "Wow, I am. Why am I riled up? It's just no reason for it, whatsoever." And so then I, been able to have that awareness, was very helpful for me. So that happened. And then the other incident that happened was I was, driving because I, and, then there was a red light. And so then the Muni, train was coming. And then, so you had to wait, for the Muni train to come for those in San Francisco. They know how, they're on the tracks. And so you have to, wait, regarding that aspect of it. And so I was waiting. At the red light where it was going. And then there was a bus, behind me, regarding an aspect of it. And I kept hearing someone, honking. And I'm like, "Why are you honking? It's a red light and the Muni is coming, so I can't move, regarding that aspect of it." And so then the bus driver, gets out, comes and said that, "Well, you need to go there because the train can't come because I'm blocking the thing." And then I say, "Well, it's not my fault that you're blocking the road." So it's just like this whole like negativity immediately just, comes out. And it's just like, "Wow, Vincent, where is this coming from? What is it that is causing me to be in that state of mind of just saying, thank you, I appreciate that. And I will go ahead and, move out of the way so you can be able to allow the train to come in." And so just amazing how our thoughts and how these negativity can just like that, be able to come. But the beauty of it, and at least for me, is being able to have an awareness of it and recognizing that my part in it and turning it over and help me shift my thinking and realize, wow, Vincent, you don't need to be in that dark space. Allow yourself to see the light, even in that situation. And so it was just like, man, what is happening with me? What is going on there? And so it was just really those two examples right there was just things I had to catch myself of being in that state of mind. And then the Course tells us this, fear and grief are your guests, and they go with you and abide with you on the way. But the dark journey is not the way of God's Son. Walk in light and do not see the dark companions, for they are not fit companions for the Son of God, who was created of light in light. Walk in light and do not see the dark companion. This quote, this beautiful message that the Course continues to share with us, had me just to, you know, reflect on other things that entered my minds where I do not sometimes allow the light to come in. And the reason why I don't allow the light to come in, because I'm in my own fear. You know, I've had fear among a lot of different things in my life. But one of the fears that tends to come up, you know, it comes and it goes. But recently it was more heavily. And that's fear regarding finances. You know, it is something that I've always stressed over. Something that I always have like huge worry of that. Just that whole insecurity of, you know, wondering, you know, what's going to ever happen, you know, to me when it comes to financial situations regarding aspect of it. To the point, this week on Monday, it had been so heavy on me, which I didn't realize, is I cannot even go to work. I took the day off and all I did was just stay in bed. And I realized of how much that was just draining me, just that energy of negative thoughts, of feeling like I'm going to never, ever be able to get to the point in my life where I feel completely comfortable when it comes to financial situations. And I think part of it, you know, is because, you know, when I go over my, you know, monthly bills and stuff like that, it's just becoming very overwhelming. And one of the things, one of the biggest things that really, you know, stands out for me is the amount of money that I have to pay for my student loans back, and how that just takes so much energy out of me. And I remember of asking myself, Vincent, what can you do to help relieve some of this anxiety, some of this darkness that you're having regarding finances, regarding the fact that you have, you know, lots of bills to pay for, just like everyone else does regarding an aspect of it, especially when it comes to, you know, my bill regarding my student loan. And then a shift happened and I was guided to just reach out to the student loan folks and ask, can I have my payments reduced? Because it was just outrageous of how much that I am supposed to, you know, pay, you know, monthly. And so I called and I spoke to the representative, and they said that, well, the reason why you have to pay so much is because of the salary that you have. And that's because that's what they go by. They go on based on your salary. And I'm like, okay, yes, I get that. I make a decent salary for here, you know, living here in San Francisco. And then I say, but also I live in a region that is very expensive. So maybe for some people who make the salary I have, yes, they can afford that. But I live in an area that is, very expensive, and so it just didn't feel right, regarding that, aspect of it. And so during my conversation with, the individual, then they came up with some options, and then those options really helped, me to be able to, ease things. And after the conversation regarding that aspect of it, it came down to the fact that they were able to reduce my student loan payments by half of what I was paying for. And so even initially, I was having all this darkness, all this doubt, all this fear, all this insecurity that was coming up for me regarding finances. And all I had to do, and that was the guidance from the spirit, is just to reach out and talk to them. Let them know your situation, what is going on, and how that you just totally shifted and changed for me. It was such a wonderful lesson for me of how to be able to go from the darkness and into the light. And then the course reminds us of this. The great light always surrounds you and shines out from you. The great light always surrounds you and shines out from you. And in that situation, it was the great light, it was there. And it was just up to me to be able to see that and to be able to recognize that, and to actually understand that in essence, I am fortunate that I do have a stable job, with the city. I've been there for 32 years and I have a nice retirement. I have health insurance for the rest of my life. So I have all these things that I recognize that I have the privilege to be able to have, and some folks don't even have that. And so when those negative thoughts comes into my mind regarding my own insecurity regarding finances, it's important for me to remember that and to remember the great light that exists. And also to be truthful and to be having the awareness that the fact is, if I've ever get into a situation where I can't take care of myself or something happens, I have a lot of resources around me. And I know that. And a lot of folks may not have that. And I'm blessed for that. And so, in order for me to continue to remind myself to get out of that darkness when it comes to finance and into the light, it is important for me to recognize the resources that I do have and that I do not have to buy into the ego wanting to come in and bring me down because they're like, no. You got to stress over this. No. You got to worry about this. No. You got, it's like, no, I don't need to. It is not needed. And that's so important for me to remember and to just really, keep in mind regarding that aspect of it. And the other thing that I've been struggling with and learning and how to get better at shifting from my darkness and into the light is forgiveness. That's one of the things that the course has continued to put into our mindset of how to forgive this world that we are in. And how to truly forgive, which in my mind is to being able to let go of grievances. And I, realized that I still was holding on to some grievances as it relates to my softball. I, talked about this, a while back ago, regarding an incident that, took place with one of our players and how I was not, pretty. I was not in favor with the outcome of the way that they approached it, because in my mind, as a course student, they were punishing someone and not allowing people to make mistakes and being able to correct those mistakes. And so that was hard. It's very hard for someone who studies the course to see how people condemn others with not coming, from a very loving place. And so one of these individuals who sort of kind of really pushed to have this particular player who made a mistake, banned, is now on the board. And so, which means that I have to interact with this person because I'm the commissioner, of the league. And so, and this individual is part of the board now. And so I have to like figure out how I'm going to be able to deal with this when I still realize that I haven't truly let it go of my own grievances towards the individual. And then, of course, reminds us the dark companions, the dark way are all illusions. Wow. The dark companions, the dark way, they're all illusions. And the thing is, and the truth of the matter is, all I have to do is just remind myself, guess what, Vincent? Just turn it over. Just turn it over to the Holy Spirit. And by turning it over to the Holy Spirit, it reminded me that everyone is a holy child of God. Regardless whether I agree with how they approach something regarding an aspect of it, I can still see them in a light. And when I'm able to see them in a light, and guess what? I'm getting myself out of darkness. I am not allowing my mind to stay stuck in something that is not necessary. And then the Course tells us, turn toward the light, for the little spark in you is part of a light so great that it can sweep you out of all darkness forever. Turn toward the light. For that little spark in you is part of a light so great that it can sweep you out of all darkness forever. And for me, that happened. And it happened this past week on Friday, where several players that I coach was playing in a different league, and they asked me to go and watch them play on a Friday night. And what such a joy. What such light that it felt just to be around them. And it helped me to realize all the other stuff really doesn't matter. Because I have this core group of people in my life, in my softball world, that brings me nothing but joy and light. And that's what I have to remember. And that's what I have to put on the forefront. And today, I will be going to meet several people from softball, you know, cleaning in with Reverend Peter. It's like this whole fairy family that we have. We're all going to get together and hang out for 3 hours playing softball. That's light. It's finding those things that bring us joy that helps us get out of the darkness. And that's what I'm realizing. And that's what I'm starting to have more of awareness of when these things comes up. Because negativity comes up. It happens. It's just the way this world is. I will have moments where I slip and don't allow myself to truly forgive someone. But yet, I have the tools and the belief and the self-awareness to know that I can shift and change and get myself out of that darkness by being able to see the light in others, to see the light that actually already exists in me. The light that exists in each and every one of us. So when we get into those moments where we get into that dark space, whether for me, when it was with my finances or how it just really ate at me, or when I found myself making comments, which was not necessary, is to take a step back, take a moment, and remember to see the light actually really exist in this world that we are in. Because we have the choice. We have the belief to be able to change that at any moment, at any time that we want. And when we're able to do that, that is when we are able to experience the joy, experience the love. And guess what? Sending out nothing but healing and loving thoughts into this world, because we got ourselves out of that darkness and into the light. And that is my talk.
Nel nome del Padre, Figliolo, Spirito Santo. Amen.
Such a separation.
Have you been lonely? Have you been sad?